wonderful. We're back at Arnold. Brings back so many memories. Well, what really would bring back these memories and make it alive is the actors who were here. This is one of the families in my lifetime that I treasure very, very much. The cast of Happy Days, ladies and gentlemen. Just finished this great softball game in which Henry outpitched me. He was the winner. Cunningham Hardware played the Arnold's team. But this is Arnold's now, where we're lying here.
This is unbelievable.
Look how far away you're sitting. You're in the reunion of Charles and Charles. Here. So hello, the reunion show here. Come over here. We have something special. If you look, we put together an homage. Homage means a lot of film clips that salute the days of Arnold's. Let's take a look.
Can you believe this? This is Arnold's.
Yeah.
I've been waiting all my life to come here. I can't. Well, this is Arnold's.
We're sophomores now, Rich. We're entitled. Man, oh man, we got it made in the shade. Hey.
Wait, here she comes. Be cool. Right.
Come on, honey, I'm a whole day.
Watch this.
Miss. Miss. Miss.
Oh, I quit.
Wait a minute, Arnold. The paper said Mitsumo Takahashi is giving the class.
I am Mitsumo Takahashi. Is this the face of Arnold?
Why'd you change your name?
What change? I buy a restaurant, had a big sign, Arnold's. Sign's very expensive. You know how many letters in Takahashi?
We got the first challenge dance of the evening.
Shake, baby, shake. Shake, baby, shake. Shake, baby, shake. Shake, baby, shake. Come on, baby. Oh, that is shaking going on.
There you go. Let's bring back. Those bring back a few memories, but you know, people sometimes used to come after the show and they would take some of these things as souvenirs. The one pennant that I still have from Northwestern.
You got that from Northwestern.
Northwestern, Richie went
to journalism school.
We will hang it up later.
You know, right outside the entrance, there's a ledge. And this ledge would be out there, and we would put our coffee cups down. And I wrote on this ledge, like here it says, Ron found out he was going to be a father today, August 31st, 1979. Oh, I found out I was going to be a father today, 9/15/1979.
Wow.
And here it says, Arnold's is being burned down this Friday, November 30th.
Better take the ledge.
1979, and that is the show that we shot to burn down Arnold's.
Yes, it was either have a wedding or burn down something. That's what you do in a sweep. You gotta get a rating.
We had
a burn down. One of us in this room caused it to burn down.
Yes.
Should we name names or
no?
We don't know?
Yeah, just point your finger.
I didn't write it.
But we're not mad at you. We like you. Oh, Happy Days always had hugging. Oh. Let's see the proof of this burning down.
Hey, Chad, you want to walk me home?
Every step of the way.
Weren't you supposed to do something before you left?
Yeah, lock up. Other Fonzie's here. He'll take care of it. Don't worry about it. There's a fire out there!
What are you talking about?
There is a fire out there!
Look!
Holy moly.
There's an outside wall. I wonder what it's made of.
Concrete.
What? Don't be changing this, will you?
Right.
All right.
You got it?
I guess everything's all right.
Yeah. Except for Arnold's.
We were all kept backstage in between acts. And we were forbidden to come anywhere near the set. So we didn't see it until the next act opened, and we all came out at the same time. And boy, I still get a lot of money. It was really like the place had been destroyed, and I thought the series was over with.
The one reason we were so emotional about the whole situation was it was more than a set. During rehearsal, that's where we'd sit down and discuss our lives.
I can't believe that. Arnold's. A booth. In this booth. Fonzie taught us a lot in this booth.
He was just getting to the good stuff.
The man trusted you. What'd you do, send your brain on vacation?
Fonzie, it was an accident.
No, accidents just happen. This is your fault. You caused this. Irresponsibility.
I'm sorry.
But it all worked out. But still, we did make those mistakes. I think we have a few mistakes. You want to see some of the mistakes you made?
Some of those.
If you don't like them, turn your head.
Okay.
Happy Days cast in. Bloopin'.
Happy Days won't be seen tonight. Arnold, tell them why.
Oh, sure.
Hi, Mom. Hi, Dad.
Hi, Dad.
Terrible dream.
Me too.
I dreamt I was in show business. Happy Days.
Let's sing.
Oh, how about I Found My Thrill?
Oh, who gives?
You want to dance first or go right out to the heavy stuff? Go right out to the heavy stuff.
How do you feel?
I gotta take a.
We were doing the same thing 20 years ago tonight.
Did you sneeze then?
No, but somebody's in the room.
Aren't you worried about the Malachi Brechers? The Malachi Brechers?
Oh, Howard, they could play at the annual Leopard Lodge Poopah Doodoo.
He tried to send Elaine home.
That's
I did it again. It's Eileen.
Okay, here we go. Take him.
I get so confused with so many.
You remember the girl with the motorcycle, all dressed in pink? Pinky Putz.
He tried to send Elaine home.
I wanted to watch the fight, but I don't know my next line.
We'll be eating at
we'll be eating at, I haven't got the slightest idea.
Be right back with more Happy Days cast reunion.
Coming up, our funniest practical jokes, some very special surprise guests, and the most talked about moment in Happy Days history.
Fonz is going to jump over a shark.
With
Welcome back, everybody. We're here at Arnold's celebrating our Happy Days 30th anniversary reunion, and we got questions from the audience. Did you see the questions?
No,
they're printed out rather nicely. Wow. These audience people have little computers.
Yeah.
It's very
nice
good.
Colors.
One of the questions here is for you, Donnie Post. Where did you pick up your signature line, "I've still got it"? Didn't he say?
That's a great question, because I have to attribute that to a man that we all love dearly and who's smiling at us right now, and that's Jerry Paris, who directed the bulk of the shows. And Jerry had an incredible personality. He used to have this saying, and then he said, "You should say it in this episode," and it was, "I still got it." And that was Jerry's.
I still got it, baby.
I still got it. So even 30 years later, I still got it.
Okay, another question is, this is a fan asks, I'm gonna sit a minute because my feet are hurting. This fan asks, how many shows did Happy Days spin off? We had an episode where Fonzie and Richie met some girls from the other side of the tracks, you know, girls who weren't so classy. And the First one, I thought it was my sister Penny. She does that so well. Penny comes from the Bronx, New York, like I and her friend Sydney Williams, and they came on, and there they were. They became Laverne and Shirley.
Hey, Fonzie!
Hey, the Fonzie, they're here. All right. Laverne, this is Laverne DeFazio, she's mine. And this is Shirley Feeney, she's yours, as you can see.
Nice to meet you, Richie.
My pleasure.
Hey, they're getting along pretty well, huh? Hey, plant it here, girls, plant it here.
I'm trying to sit down.
Staring? How'd you like your eyes closed for good, huh?
You're too much, Laverne.
So, Cheryl, what do you think of this kid? You've been with worse.
Oh, he's nice. And a tie, too.
And a hanky. Is that for showing or for blowing? I'm ready, Fonz.
What about Shirley?
She's putting on her makeup.
How come?
Because I held her face under the sink.
Hey, listen, tell me the truth. Why did you and Laverne get into that fight anyway?
Well, when Laverne and I went into the ladies' room, I walked up to her and I said, sweet as you please, Laverne, you have a mouth like a sewer, which she does. And she said, a sewer? And I said, yeah, a sewer. So she curled up her chubby little hand and... Oh! Are you all right? Oh, Richie, I'm so sorry. Oh, dear. Oh, here, let me kiss a boo-boo.
Richie, we're home.
This was a cast of actors who were very secure. If you bring a new actor on the show, they say, why is he getting all the funny lines? Or why is she getting? Why don't I get that? These people never did that. They met Laverne and Shirley, they said, you know they're funny. And then Robin Williams came on, and we all looked and said, this guy, look at this. He's a genius.
That might have been the most difficult week that I ever did, because your whole job was not to laugh. And he never did anything twice the same, so you could never get used to it.
Wait a minute, who are you?
I am Mark, from Mark.
Your buzzer.
Why don't you make yourself comfortable?
Oh, thank you.
You want to move?
Let us make it official. We must introduce the local celebrities.
Uncle.
Yeah.
Now I must leave your planet Earth, but I trip my crippler to you, sir.
Anyway, he was just one of the many wonderful spin-offs. Let's look at the Happy Days family tree and who came from that tree.
Look at this, an indoor statue. Oh, look at this chair.
A formal introduction is at hand.
Buddy, buddy.
Get down. I am Mark from Mark.
Nanu, nanu.
I'm Mindy McConnell. Ta-da, ta-da.
We've got it all together now, gang. The Fonz. His doggy name, Mr. Cool, and the Good Group. Future chick named Cupcake. Hey.
Something magic in the way you hold me in your eyes.
No one ever warned me love just takes you by surprise. I don't know what's come over me. You got me hypnotized. When you look at me,
when we return our exclusive practical jokes. Plus, the cast remembers the show's most emotional moments.
I just want to tell you that I love you.
When the Happy Days 30th anniversary...
Celebrating our Happy Days 30th anniversary.
Reunion.
Thank you. You know, we did do a lot of serious stuff, and one of the most movie experiences I had in the show is this group in Massachusetts called and said, we have abused children here, and it's hard to get through to them because they have no emotion. They never cry. But the one thing we noticed, they all love Happy Days because they love Fonzie because he never, ever cries. And this episode was designed where Richie almost died. That was all designed for that group. And the result was those kids watched, and then the counselors could talk to them about tears are not a bad thing. So that was, to me, one of the most
awesome
highlights of the series. Let's take a look.
How is he?
Well, he's not very good, Fonzie, but there is a chance.
Is there anything I could do?
Nothing.
Sir, gotta have a little chat here. It's my best friend, Richie, and he's in really bad shape. Yeah, I know you know that. But the world is kind of going a little wacko, you know, and you think you need people down here like him? And if you don't, I do. I can fix a lot of things, but this one is all yours. So let's make a little deal. You do this for me, and I'll owe you one.
Well, Arthur, you just go home now and get some sleep.
Yeah, Marion's right.
Yeah, you're both right, but I ain't going.
Couldn't you're not going to do yourself any good by
it's
staying
so bad,
here.
You can go and get some rest.
Come on, now.
Quiet down. You're giving me a headache.
Quiet, Richard, and don't interrupt your father.
Thank you. Look, fine.
Richard! Oh, Richard, are you
you're okay?
Is Lori Beth all right?
Oh, she's fine, just fine.
Oh, good. So,
you live to do another episode, which we were going. You did very well, by the way.
Yeah,
it was a very nice scene. Let's hear it for him.
I agree.
We did have other moments. We had writers of all ages on the show. I had young kids coming up, 18 out of college, and I had writers who were over 70. So I would bunch them all together so they'd learn something, you know, from each other. But they wrote some serious things, too. We had some serious shows. Let's take a look at some of these moments that were a little more serious than others and all part of the makeup of Happy Days.
Harebrained, irresponsible
hair
things.
Brain.
I've got to be in a meeting in a half an hour, and I don't have any dinner, and I've got a limp fez.
Marion, do this. Marion, do that. You want your dinner? I'll get your dinner. You got it. I'll get your dinner. 1,000 times I can do it with my eyes closed. He is your salad, your vegetable, your meat. Let it up!
Look, would it help if I said I wouldn't look at any other girls?
Yes.
Fine, then. I won't look at any other girls.
You're lying.
Yes, I am. I have to be crazy to say that. Everybody looks at a pretty girl, Joni.
Yeah.
Just tell me what I have to do to get us back together again.
You don't want to say anything? We won't talk. Then we'll go home. You know why? Because there are a lot of people worried about you.
I'll leave when I damn well feel like leaving.
Good plan. Good plan. If something in my soul tells me that you want to leave right now. So, Richie, put the beer down and let's go home, okay?
I wrote this to you this morning because I knew that when we were face to face like this that, well, I might not be able to find the words. How do you thank somebody who's been everything to you? Your brother, your protector. You delivered my own child. I just don't know how I could ever say that.
I think you just did.
You see, we were serious. We had that music sneaking in all the time. And I think a lot of the times, you know, when we had some serious shows or something, we would kid around on the set, and that would kind of lighten us up.
I don't know if this is a practical joke. It's just, maybe I was just annoying. When Henry was on stage once in a while, I would stand in the bathroom here or behind this sort of grill work over there with spitballs. This was during the actual show, by the way. And I would unload on Henry. And I knew like three or four lines before the scene was over, and I was gone. I ran out the stage door because he would kill me.
We managed to embarrass each other constantly. How about some practical jokes that maybe I can remember?
Sweet, Arthur.
Yeah.
How come Richard doesn't have to go?
Because he's older than you and he can take care of himself.
Well, every time we leave him alone, he locks himself out of the house.
I don't lock myself out.
Yes, you do.
Oh, never mind, dear. Here's some cookies for you. Just for the trip, so he won't get cranky.
Well, they're all crushed.
I know. Every time I go to the supermarket, some old man knocks my cart over.
Well, don't go to that market.
I won't. I just hate that store. I heard this morning this...
We thought that we were on cable. We were having a time. There's more when we return.
Up next, we surprise the cast with two very special guests. Plus, a Happy Days urban legend is finally laid to rest.
There he goes.
When the Happy...
We're back. We're celebrating the Happy Days 30th anniversary reunion. And we got questions coming up, and we got one for Scott Baio. What were the perks and problems of being a teenage heartthrob?
I don't really think there was a downside.
The problem always was that these young ladies liked me for me, or that
I didn't care.
You didn't care what they liked you.
How old were you when you came to the show?
I think I was 15.
The thing is that Ron decided to go on to be a director, and then Scott had to step up and kind of fill the position, and he hit a home run every time.
My cousin won't cheat.
I don't need your stinking job. I've been doing all right without it. Without you, without school, without anybody. And I'll tell you something else, Fonzarelli. I don't need your stupid cap.
Stupid cap? Stupid cap? It's a very good thing that I don't got a bad temper.
We have a question here for you.
All right.
Because you literally grew up on Happy Days.
Oh, yeah.
But before you answer the question, let's all look at why we all love Joni Shortcake Cunningham.
Gee, Scarsdale's gonna tell us where babies come from. She's got a book with pictures and everything.
If you sit right down, I will drive you to school.
If this Spike tries to put his arm around you in the movie theater, you just tell him that you are not that kind of a girl.
Hey, this is my sex talk.
Yes.
Why can't you treat me like a grown-up?
You're absolutely right, dear. Get somebody to help you cross the street.
Hey, Mom, can we have another talk about boys?
I think you should get a man's point of view this time.
Yeah, maybe you're right. I'll talk to Fonzie tomorrow.
For every action a man's got, you got a counteraction, you dig it?
Why?
What?
Hey, Blue Eyes. I'm delivering a kissogram for Joni Cunningham. Stamp it, return to sender.
Ah, Snow White, you're a vision of loveliness.
Well, well, the eighth dwarf, pushy.
This is your last chance. You're gonna go out with me?
Maybe.
Al, guess what? I got a maybe!
Chachi and I have finally done something that we've wanted to do for a long time, and I hope you approve.
Will you marry me? Oh, Chach, what?
Oh, Chach, yes!
You are perfect.
Sweetheart, I have never seen you look more beautiful.
I now pronounce you man and wife. You may kiss the bride.
Was that a flood of memories?
Oh, yeah.
The best thing about it is that when I am approached by most people, I get, you know, I grew up with you. You're like my own daughter. It's wonderful.
You are a great growing up child, and we're glad you're still with us at the reunion. But let me ask Anson a question. You know what, Anson?
What? Yes.
You sang quite a bit on Happy Days.
I tried, yes. Yes.
The right atrium's where the process begins, where the CO2 blood enters the heart. Through the tricuspid valve to the right ventricle, the pulmonary artery and lungs. Once inside the lungs, it dumps its carbon dioxide and picks up its oxygen supply. Then it's back to the heart, through the pulmonary vein, through the atrium and left ventricle.
So the question was, how is it going? You're still singing as much as you do. What do you, I know you're a great director. We are a wonderful director. Directs so many shows, directed me.
That's in right, show. Sabrina.
Sabrina the Teenage Witch.
That's right,
was,
that's right.
I was and there, and he was saying, Gary, move over.
Yeah, come on, get in the two shot, Nick. Get over, come on.
You always taught me, from day one, you said, wear as many hats as you can.
It's a fickle business.
No, he said, and Anson, I've seen your acting, wear five hats. He encouraged us. So I've been, you know,
direct,
basically
produce,
directing, producing,
acting.
Yeah,
you do it all. That's the kind of business. You got to do it all.
That's true. That's true.
But you know who's doing it pretty well? Him.
He's okay.
He's all right. There's a question for you. Okay. Since 1974, you have not taken that hat off. Stupid question. Here's the question. How has Happy Days influenced your career?
A lot of ways. I mean, first of all, I learned another kind of comedy. You know, as a kid growing up, did the Andy Griffith Show. It was kind of a mellow sort of humor. A
lot of whistling.
Jerry Paris directing us at this incredible tempo. When I did go and I started directing, I was prepared for that kind of problem solving.
There must have been hard moments when you were stressed out and you wanted to do something.
So many moments like that.
I mean, I go play softball. What do you do when you get...
I will admit there have been times when I don't sing it out loud, but I'll hum.
Hum?
What? I found my 3-0. And there's always Blueberry Hill. That's a catchy tune.
I found my thrill.
That's my trademark.
I found my thrill. You better believe it.
I found my thrill on Blueberry Hill.
I found my thrill.
Johnny.
On Blueberry Hill.
We're apart. You're a part of me still. For you were my thrill.
On Blueberry Hill.
There's more when we return.
Coming up, the cast welcomes not one, but two surprise guests. And the legendary moment you've all been waiting for. The Fonz jumps the shark.
Shark? That is the stupidest thing I've ever heard.
When the Happy Days 30th birds.
Welcome back. We're reminiscing here with our Happy Days cast, and we're talking about the old days, and I'm reminiscing about all our writers, Bob Brunner, Lowell Gans, Mark Rothman, Babalu Mandel, Brian Levand, and all those guys combined came up with the question the audience just asked. What is the story about jumping the shark? We all know jumping the shark is now a phrase in all of our television lore. Before we answer, let's take a look at this particular little moment that became an urban legend.
Rich,
go quick.
What, is there something wrong?
It's a shark.
The Fonz.
Fonz got eaten by a shark?
He did? Who said that?
Not me.
What are you talking about, Rich? You just said a shark.
No, Fonz is going to jump over a shark.
Shark. That is the stupidest thing I've ever heard.
Stupid, yes. Also dumb, but it's something I gotta do.
Fonz, you're not jumping over garbage cans on a bike. You're jumping over a shark. On nothing, on a couple of little skis. One little slip and chomp, chomp, chomp.
Not for your support. Look, I was challenged. I gotta jump.
Ready to make the jump. There he goes!
Explain what it is. Jumping the shark is the phrase that right. they use when a show does an episode which puts the show downhill and it's going to be canceled soon.
Right, it's called too far.
Too far. It's called the Jumping the Shark episode, named after our little Jumping the Shark. Oh, but we must say proudly, after our Jumping the Shark episode, we ran 100 more episodes. So yeah. we didn't jump too badly. All right, Mr. Bosley, Tom. You were recently voted by TV Guide as one of the television's 10 top fathers in the history of television. This man right here.
You know, people used to say to me, how are you such a good father at home? And I would say, look, on the show, the words are written for me. When I'm home, it's ad-lib 24 hours a day. But here, it was all written, but the feeling was there.
Yeah. Very nice. That's very nice. The next question is for you, Marion. It's the most asked questions about the Happy Days series. When the series began, you had another son. You had an older son. His name was Chuck.
Oh, yes.
Look at this a moment. See if this kind of jogs your memory and see two Chucks.
Why is it that this family just can't sit together for 5 minutes after dinner and talk?
Dad, I gotta practice. See, I'm changing my free throw from an underhand to an overhand. Looks better for the fans.
Oh, well, then you're excused, Chuck. I certainly wouldn't want to disappoint your fans. Night, Chuck.
I'm sleeping on the couch?
No, in the couch. It's one of those fold-out beds.
It's where my old room used to sack out.
Oh.
I guess that'd be all right. Yeah. Oh.
Hey, there it is. Well, clean your little heart out.
Aren't you gonna help me?
Well, the best way I can help you is just to stay out of your way. Later, little brother.
Mom! I'm home!
Listen!
Hey, Dad, can I borrow the car?
Here they are! We found your sons, would you believe it? How you been?
Been great.
Well, it's 30 years. It was short, but I feel like I'm coming home.
Well, we love these family reunions, and we're very glad the two Chucks came back because you know what you're in time for? Another break. As we continue, we are back again, and we're winding down because, you know, these chairs are rented. So we're going to move along. And the question that every...
Can I say one thing before we do this? You know, you're watching Gary, and he's really funny, and that's why this show was as funny as it was.
To 30 golden years. Happy anniversary, everybody.
This, you have to reflect back on what you've done and on what you've accomplished. Marion and I have not climbed Mount Everest or written the great American novel, but we've had the joy of raising two wonderful kids, and I guess no man or woman could ask for anything more. So thank you all for being part of our family. To happy days.
I am so glad that we shared this party together.
And I wouldn't have missed it for the world. And I want to thank all of you for sharing with us what's been an incredible day. Good night, everybody.
Good night.
Thank you so much. Oh, wait a minute. Henry, come on. For old time's sake.
Are you kidding?
Come on, do it.